49ers versus Seahawks pre-show here on the 49ers_News 24 Central. If you guys are new to the channel, subscribe, like the video, and let's go right into the pre-show. This is the practice report for the 49ers for October 8th, Tuesday. The 49ers player that did not practice were Hufanga with a torn ligament. He will be out for 4 weeks / month. Demetrius Fleming Flowers did not practice. Jake Moody will also be out for a month. Did not practice, of course. Jordan Elliott did not practice. Limited in practice, Tre'Davious Ward, Chris Conley, George Kittle, Fred Warner, and Jair Brown. That is your 49ers practice report and / injury update for the 49ers. Let's get into the key players for both teams. We're going to start off with the Seahawks. The Seahawks key players, number one, DK Metcalf. DK Metcalf is the most targeted Seahawks player right now. He also leads the team in receiving yards. He is way above Tyler Lockett, their second receiving leader, by a lot, over 100 yards. I think it's like 140 more receiving yards than Tyler Lockett. He is the key player. The 49ers need to make sure they contain DK Metcalf if they want to win this game. Number two is K9, Kenneth Walker. Kenneth Walker is a guy who makes defenses miss many, many tackles in the backfield to get positive yards. But sometimes he just be breaking tackles and don't be going nowhere. But Kenneth Walker is a threat for this 49ers defense that struggles to tackle late in the game. The 49ers need to make sure Kenneth Walker does not get going, because Kenneth Walker could get going and it could be a long day for that 49ers defense. Number three, Devon Witherspoon. Devon Witherspoon will have the matchup of Juwan Jennings or Brandon Ayuk. It's most likely going to be Juwan Jennings. That will be a fun matchup. I also believe Witherspoon will be coming on a lot of blitzes for the Seattle Seahawks, so the 49ers need to make sure the line protects Purdy and do not let Witherspoon get through on the corner blitzes that the Ravens were bringing last year on Christmas Day to Brock Purdy. Those are the three key players for the Seahawks. Now let's get into the three key players for the 49ers. Number one, Jordan Mason. Jordan Mason needs to have the ball in his hands at least 16 times on the ground. He needs at least 16 carries in this game. He needs some running back screens out the backfield. He needs the ball in his hand at least a lot of times in this football game, at least 16 carries on the ground, and just a lot of receptions in this game, because the Seattle Seahawks, they struggle to stop halfbacks out the backfield. So screen passes are going to be 49ers' best friends in this game. Those screen passes, throw short passes to Jordan Mason and let him cook. The Seahawks are allowing 128 rushing yards. Get the ball to Jordan Mason. Run game and pass game. Jordan Mason needs to be cooking in this game on Thursday night versus the Seattle Seahawks. And the second key player is Deebo Samuel. I do believe Deebo Samuel will be cooking in this game for the Seattle Seahawks out the backfield, out the, of course, in his wide receiver position. I think it's going to be a big Deebo Samuel game. He played one game since he came back from his injury against the Arizona Cardinals. He had one catch on the wide receiver screen. Other than that catch, Deebo Samuel did not have a other reception in that game for the Cardinals. But look for Deebo Samuel to have a big game versus the Seattle Seahawks. A lot of yak yards could be coming from Deebo Samuel. The third key player for the 49ers is their brand new kicker, Matthew Wright. How will Matthew Wright perform in the brightest lights Thursday night football on the road, a NFC West opponent for the 49ers? Matthew Wright needs to be absolutely perfect for the San Francisco 49ers. Those are your key players for the 49ers. Let's get into the keys to win for the 49ers. The first key to win is run the ball. The Seahawks are allowing 128 rushing yards, like I said earlier. Get the ball to Jordan Mason. Let him cook. Get him involved in the halfback screen plays. Throw a lot of screen passes in this game for the Seahawks. They cannot stop it. A lot of check downs to Jordan Mason is needed for the 49ers to blow out the Seattle Seahawks. Number two, red zone offense. The 49ers red zone offense has been absolutely horrible. Kyle Shanahan needs to scheme up some plays in the red zone, specifically for the red zone, that could get the 49ers in the end zone to score 6 and that 3. The red zone offense needs 6 and that 3 points. The 49ers need to score touchdowns in this game and not let Matthew Wright come out and kick a field goal many times in this game. Number three, stopping DK Metcalf. DK Metcalf, like I said earlier, is the top target for Geno Smith. He needs to make sure that the 49ers contain DK Metcalf before he will have a big game for this team. Of course, Tre'Davious Ward has not been playing his best football at all this year. He's been dealing with some injuries, but he has just not been looking like himself. So that could be a big problem for the 49ers if Tre'Davious Ward is on DK Metcalf. So hopefully the 49ers contain DK Metcalf at some point. to allow him to not have a big game versus this 49ers defense. Those are your keys to win for the 49ers. The Seahawks did allow 7 sacks last week to the New York Giants. Look for Nick Bosa to have a huge game versus the Seattle Seahawks offensive line. Nick Bosa is going to be able to cook the Seahawks offensive line. Look for him to have a big game. The Seahawks will blitz Brock Purdy a lot, just like the Ravens did the 49ers last year on Christmas. Look for the Seahawks to bring design blitzes like Devon Witherspoon coming on a corner blitz. Look for that to be happening a lot to Brock Purdy. Those are just some notes to watch for out in the game. If you guys enjoyed, drop by, subscribe to the channel. And that was your 49ers vs. Seahawks pre-show.